I appreciate the introduction. This evening we're going to talk about something called melanin. It's what everyone is concerned about in the world. It's what they have a meeting about every 3 to 5 years. Germany, Italy, France, the U.S., they meet every 3 to 5 years and have a melanin convention and discuss the latest research in melanin. They have never invited a black scientist to that meeting in history. So we have had our own melanin conferences where we discuss this information involving melanin. Melanin is commonly associated with the pigment that causes your skin to be brown. So we figure that that's what melanin is about. But it's a little more than just the pigment that makes your skin brown. It's what we call a chemical key to life. The more melanin you have, the more civilized you are. The more melanin you have, the more psychic you are. The more melanin you have, the more information your brain can store. The more melanin you have, the faster the nerve transmissions are. The more melanin you have, the more sound you absorb in your ear, so you hear the full range of sound. No other race can do that. The more melanin you have, the more color you can absorb in your eyes. That's why your eyes are brown. You actually see the full color. You see this color, where white folks see a paler tan. Because the more melanin you have, the more you can see what God has meant for you to see. The more melanin you have in your taste buds, the more you can taste the full flavor of the food. No other race can taste an apple like you can, because they can't absorb the full flavor, because you need melanin to absorb the full flavor of food. That's why we combine food differently from other races, because we actually can taste the food. That's because of the high amount of melanin we have, which we sometimes take for granted. Melanin is the chemical key to life. There is nothing else to study in science but melanin. We call it chemi, which means black. The people who study melanin particles call what they're studying, the scientists call chemistry, which you call chemistry, the study of melanin particles that go around in an orbit, and we call them electrons, protons, solitons. Those are melanin particles. That's why we call it chemistry. And the country you come from is called Kemet, which some people call Egypt. There is nothing else to study but melanin. And if you study chemistry or heard of chemistry and haven't heard the word melanin, you have just been studying social science. You go into a classroom and you call it biology, but biology is the way melanin controls the cell. And we call that little melanin sitting in the cell the new sun, the nucleus. The new sun radiates information and tells the cell how to operate, how to think, how to digest. That's melanin. Biology is the study of melanin and how it communicates. There's nothing else to study in if you're going into the living sciences. Melanin plays a part in your historical memory. The more melanin you have, the more you're connected to your ancestors. You can pull on thoughts that you didn't even know were there, because melanin gives you ancestral memory. That's based on melanin. That's how we classify races, based on their melanin content. It's not the quality of melanin in your skin we're talking about. It doesn't mean a light-skinned brother is less black than you are. We're talking about the melanin produced inside their body by the pineal gland. That's the melanin we measure. Every living thing has to have melanin. White people have it, but they have a lesser amount. And their melanin is different from your melanin. Their melanin has sulfur in the middle, and your melanin has selenium in the middle. They're two different types of melanin that could not biologically come down the same tree. That's physiologically impossible for a white person to evolve from a black person. It's two different melanins. That's why every scientist says that theory of evolution. We never say it's a fact. Never. We say it's the theory of evolution. It's not a fact. Theories are something you need to just get through the day. I have a theory that I'm going to be a millionaire. Helps me get through a day. But I don't know. I know it's not real. It's just a theory. And we use theories just to get through information in science. It just helps us to focus stuff. But we know they're not facts. So we never say the fact of evolution. It's a theory. It helps us focus our information, get through some research. That's all. And when we finish with the theory, we throw it away. But you pick it up and think it's a real thing. This is really a fact. No, it is not. Just stuff we make up to get through the day, keep us focused. The theory of evolution, the theory of the speed of light, the theory of gravity, the theory of this and that. They're all theories. Can't prove none of it. Theories. And so you know many of them, but you know few facts. And we're talking about the fact of melanin. We're not talking about theories right now. We know more about theories about science than we know about science. We say a theory. What comes around goes around. That's a theory. What goes up must come down. That light's up there. Why don't it fall down on the ground? You say what goes up must come down. Why don't that light fall down? What are you talking about? What goes up doesn't have to come down. That's a theory. So we know those theories, but we got to concentrate on the fact here. Melanin is the biochemical key to life. It helps you metabolize carbohydrates, causes you to use less energy to make energy, which we call conversion reactions. Less energy to make energy. We efficiently make energy because we have this melanin. Melanin is a polymer. Poly means many. It has many characters. There's gas melanin. There's liquid melanin. There's crystallized melanin. And the one thing about melanin is it can be in two places at the same time. It's the only chemical that can do that. Melanin has memory. You can't destroy melanin. Melanin starts. The foundation for any idea has to come from this darkness, come from this silence. This whole planet is sitting inside of melanin gas. It's dark out there. You think if you go outside the atmosphere of the Earth, there would be sunshine everywhere. No, it's not. It's dark. And that's melanin gas. Everything comes from this dark silence called melanin. You have to go deep within, as they say. Go deep within that melanin crystal. That's how you're born. The baby wraps around the melanin crystal, and you call it the fetus position. Then it opens up like an umbrella. That's how you're born, wrapping around the melanin crystal. And it lays the blueprint of how your muscles should grow, how your nerves should grow, how your bones should grow. It lays memory down permanently. Therefore, if I cut off your leg, somebody's going to say, leg's gone, and say, my leg hurt. You look down and say, you don't have a left leg. You say, well, it hurts. Because melanin is permanent memory. The body still knows it's a leg there. Melanin cannot be destroyed. They used to put it in vials, and they called it your holy relics. And they put it in little vials, and you find it in the pyramids of Egypt. Your holy relics. Those are melanin crystals. And people would tap into that to tap into you. That's melanin.
Aloha. I felt this is a good place to start, to jump off the last two videos and get more into the sciences of it. Like before was one perspective. The video before last was one perspective of society, of our biology, our chemistry, the experience, the humanity as a whole. And like I said, I don't completely agree with the depths, not like it's supposed to be up to me to agree with, but I just wanted to say that to the people who are out there listening to this stuff. So we can all kind of see that the information is what matters. The information is what matters. I'm not here to get like all like people angry or start feeling guilty or hating themselves or none of that stuff. That is your own reaction if you're starting to feel that way because of whatever kind of trigger that triggered you. That's not my fault. It's the way you are processing information. So the information itself is just information. But just like I said in the last video, people got in the comment sections and automatically started, you know, playing out exactly what I said. You know, you got people saying, oh, well, this guy's racist, or oh, the information doesn't matter because he mentioned, you know, planets and flat earth, or yeah, people were playing the victim role now, like, oh, well, now this and this, scientifically this, and, you know, what gets lost in there? The information gets lost. And like I said in the last video, I'm transitioning into a space of not really paying attention or wasting a lot of time in interpreting these perspectives kind of cater to their kind of responses, because it's a waste of time ultimately. Now there's too much work to do, there's too much information out there, and we can do better than that. There's a lot of, like, even in that little 8-minute clip, there's a lot of information that I wanted to break down in reference to even stuff like flat earth. So you heard Dr. Layla Africa mention evolution, and I wanted to use that as a focal point in reference to, like, how flat earth addresses evolution, and then take that into the space of what actually is the connection between the physical realm and the non-physical realm. What's the bridge? What's the chemistry? What's the math? What's the biology? Like, the spiritual biology, what is that? We don't know any kind of spiritual interpretations of the body, the mind, or the soul, because our entire universe is based upon these people who say, well, everything is just based upon the elements. It's just physical. There's no soul. There's no spirit. There's no nothing. You're just a plain old piece of meat firing chemical neurons in your brain, and you just happen to have a heartbeat. And basically, you have no meaning and no purpose because you came from a Big Bang, and you came from monkeys after that, and you're just an animal. So that's the confirmation in your world, consciously and subconsciously, that you're nothing. You have no meaning. You have no purpose. So since you have no meaning and have no purpose, go to work, do what we tell you to do, and don't question our authority, because we are the smartest monkeys in the universe. And it's been proven scientifically. End of story. So we all know that's bullshit. And a lot of people know that that perspective is bullshit from many different ways. Like, one way to see it is through flat earth. Another way to see it is through the black conscious community. Another way to see it is even through, like, religions. Like, if you make your way, and this is not to, you know, give a pass to religion or anything, I'm just speaking in reference to the connection that people make to asking questions about their reality in reference to the soul nature. So you can see how religion basically just cuts the legs out of the soul and says, well, or rips, it's basically ripping the heart out of the soul, and it says it doesn't exist. You're just an empty shell. You're a shell. You're a ghost in a shell having a physical experience, and that's it. You are the physical experience. That's it. That's what scientism does. That's what the atheistic perspective of scientism does to your conscious and your subconscious reality. Religion gives you a drive-through McDonald's commercial version of the soul, which is like, it's another way of ripping the heart out of the experience that you're having, Because everything that you're doing, everything that you're reading, everything that you're channeling is through something else. There's another step that you can take in order to be closer to whatever it is that we're calling the soul, the most high, the spirit, the non-physical reality, the ethers, whatever it is. There's a bridge there and there's a space. And then there's artificial bridges and there's artificial spaces. So we can see the artificial space of the heliocentric universe. You can see the artificial bridge of mainstream religions. And you can see the artificial bridge also of scientism, which is the mainstream religion. So we have all of these different questions that are just kind of floating out of there now. A lot of people in flat earth have these questions, but they don't have anywhere to put it. Now, like many people in the flat earth conversation say, well, you know, the design is to make us think that we have no meaning and no purpose and no connection. And now what now? Like, what are you going to do now that you're saying that? Now people are saying, well, we do have a meaning. We do have a purpose. Okay. Well, if you do, there's an intelligence behind that. There's a chemistry behind that. There's a biology, a spiritual chemistry, a spiritual intelligence behind that. What is that? And from my research over the years, melanin is not the answer. I don't think there is a answer, but it is one of the answers that are out there that help us start to question our reality from the perspective of spiritual acknowledgement, from the perspective of how I'm seeing it, the bridge between the body and the soul. Like, what is that connection? We can see the mind and your mind's eye, and Dr. Africa goes into that in reference to the pineal gland. What's in the pineal gland? Melanin. So we have this cosmic molecule in a sense. So just imagine like the cosmic molecule. And for this video, I'm going to take the perspective of Dr. Africa and then roll with it just for this video. And maybe in another video, I'll go the same kind of way in reference to Dr. Sabi's perspective, where he basically says melanin, it's not melanin. There's a difference between melanin and carbon. And basically, we're just talking about the molecular structure, the electric structure of our bodies and the chemical makeup and without melanin. But how I see it, basically saying the same sort of thing, just in a different style, a different language. So given the various teachers that are out there, the various information that's out there, it's nobody's responsibility other than your own to do this research. It's nobody's responsibility other than your own to entertain the true science, entertain the true spiritual perspective of, you know, what's going on here. If you say this is happening, if you're saying this is what you have, a meaning, you have a purpose, you have a soul, or you are the soul, we have this body, there is some kind of relationship going on here. What is that? And right now, that's where I want to start to step into, because ultimately it's always going to help you understand, overstand, and understand all of the perspectives that are on your plate, all of the perspectives that are available to you. You'll be able to interpret it more deeply when you have a variety of perspectives, you have a variety of information that ultimately says the same thing. It makes you more rich in a sense, rich in quality over just quantity, just like over and over again, saying something over and over and over again, like the earth is flat, the earth is flat, the earth is flat. I mean, that's how many times you're going to say that before you need some more information to actually help people understand that, well, it's not just about that. In fact, if you say something like that, it's weak. It's easily destroyed because there's nothing else to back it up. That's why I said, when you focus so much on flat versus globe, something gets lost there. if you take in the human story, that's when you start asking different questions and presenting different arguments that a lot of people can't really argue with. Once you get to that space, you'll realize that you don't have to argue anymore. If people are arguing, then they're not really, I mean, this is not clear cut across the board, obviously, but largely when people get into that space, they're not really discussing. They're just trying to be more righter than the next. And that's not to say that those kind of communications don't help or do anything. Largely, obviously, they do in many ways. What I'm saying is that there's another way to get to that point. There's another space to get, another way to get there and research and share and expand and, you know, even expose a lot of this information. But we have to challenge ourselves to build up our catalog, build up our perspectives, and then go there. So with this video, I'm going to go just like I was talking about the first clip that was played when this video started. I'm going to play a few more clips and then just go into the my perspective and, you know, how that fits in with all of these other storylines. Yeah, to close out the evolution storyline, we can understand why evolution was created to not only make you have no meaning and no purpose and trigger the animalistic mentality, but it was also meant to set the foundation for this whole, we're all human, we're all one, it's all that simple. It's just plain white bread, ham and cheese sandwich humanity. It's it, that's it, we're all the same. And look in those comment sections, excuse me. Go ahead and if you're interested, look in the comment sections and listen what people wrote. People were actually making fun of it. They were like joking about this information. We're talking about like the information that was spoken about by Dr. Laila Africa in his presentation, an hour-long presentation, where he was talking about genocide. He's talking about the psyche, from his perspective, the psyche of colonialism, the psyche of white supremacy, the psyche of slaughter, genocide, complete and utter destruction in every level. And you have people saying, you know, that's just get over that. We're all the same. Well, I guess I can't understand this because I'm not able to. I mean, making jokes out of this stuff. That's the mentality that people are facing with. And it's sad, really. It really is sad. Like when I read that, I'm just like, man. But that's another confirmation to me of I'm stepping out of that. This information will not be taken into account. A lot of the people who are coming from that perspective anymore. This is about the information. This is about questioning and understanding and overstanding your reality and got shit to do with your emotions, largely. If anything to do with your emotions, it's in reference to how your emotions get played by the system, how your emotions get played by the alchemy of this mind control program for you to not look into information, for you to stay stagnant, for you to water down the reality and not ever go into expanding your consciousness to expand outside of this level of constraining or destructive consciousness, this parasitic consciousness. So people, you know, bully, they'll down talk you. Oh, this guy's racist, this guy's that. They'll victimize themselves. They'll make jokes out of stuff. And, you know, for people, and this is a thing a lot of people don't see, this information that I'm talking about, the tone that I have, the way that I'm speaking right now, I don't have to have this tone with everybody. It's only certain people. Certain people have to hear this tone in order to not be focusing so much on their defensive mechanisms inside their head. See, there's people like my brothers and sisters, my family that's close to me, where if I present this information, I don't have to go into expanding it out so much because they're receiving it. They understand it. It's not like, oh, everything that you're saying is right. No, it's because they can communicate. It's like dancing. It's like dancing. It's like, to be more accurate, it's like playing in a drum circle. When you're in a tight ass groove in a drum circle, you have people from all over the world, a lot of the times, coming together in a big ass circle with their different style of drums, cowbells, tambourines, all kinds of shit. Different drums, yet they play the same song, the same music, the same harmonics. Now, what happens is, in reference to a good example of the comments in the last videos, what happens is a lot of people say, "Oh, we just all play the same song. That means we're all the same song. So nothing else matters. It's just about the same song and that's it." But what gets lost there? What happened before the song started playing? The people, the lives, the drums, the creation of those drums, the style of the individual, the life of the individual that plays that drum, all of that matters. What I'm saying is that that's an analogy of the relationship that each and every di individual, different culture and person and drum in this reality has with something like the spiritual nature of melanin or carbon or this physical reality, whatever it is that you want to call it. There's something there that is beautifully on purpose, divinely beautiful. And the new age mentality is trying to do the same thing that the evolution theory was designed to do, which was water everything down and just say, "We're all one. It's all this, it's all that." Just follow Oprah into the new age. Follow Deepak Chopra into the new age. Follow Barack Obama into the new age. Like Bernie said, this whole thing, it's like it's all, we're all struggling. We understand that now. Everybody is understanding, especially when you have an individual like Trump up there. See, Trump is another version of watering down your reality. He's there to set the bar so low that every single body in the world that says, that sees him, says to themselves, "Well, at least I'm not that bad. At least it's not that bad." And what happens? The entire psyche, the entire consciousness of the people gets lowered. It gets shrunk down to have to adjust to the focus. And these late night talk shows, these comedians, the news, the alternative news, the conspiracy theories, they make it real for you. They are your confirmation that that's the only thing that they need to focus on, that you need to focus on. And a good example of that, in reference to what Dr. Laila was talking about in this video and the next, in the last video, is the nature of the focus. You can see, like, even in a lot of these conspiracy theorists, like Alex Jones gets in there talking about, "Oh, well, 1776 will commence." He's telling you, like, the problems that we're dealing with today sprung from 1776. And you're already knowing that it's far deeper than that. So, but what's the main thing, and what I really want to focus on was the psychology of, you can hear how he's talking about all this, you know, death and destruction and all this other stuff, like the whole conspiracy theory storyline. A better example would be the news, local news and main, or yeah, the mainstream media news. You can see it's sick, it's disgusting. It's like murder, arson, robbery, and then they trigger something with like a fancy or a some kind of funny, cute little YouTube video, and then it's back to murder, rape, arson, kidnapping. And then they tell you all that because that's playing with your consciousness. It's shrinking your consciousness down to basically nothing. And when you're shrunk down so much, so many times, over so much time, you're basically a different person. You're living in another world. from a vibratory and a frequency perspective, you have been shrunk down to a McDonald's consciousness, and it inherently creates cancer. So what I'm saying is that the perspective of evolution theory and all these other theories that Dr. Laila Africa was mentioning, that it has the same effect on us as like the mainstream media does. It's just in a longer period of time, and it affects us more deeply. So now that we can understand that those things exist, we have to understand why they exist, how they affect us, and what we can do. More importantly, what we now have to do to understand, understand, and overstand what is going on, what really is going on. And what I'm saying is that a lot of these teachers, like Bobby Hemmett, Dr. Laila Africa, Dr. Sabi, a lot of these, Dr. Francis Cress Welsing, Dr. Joy DeGruy, like all these people, Professor Baina Bello, all these people have very valid perspectives. Is everybody going to be perfect? Is everybody going to be spot on? Obviously not. But the information that they're presenting, from my perspective, a lot of that information in there is gold. It's like you have to see it in some kind of way. It will help you in some kind of way. That's why I'm saying, that's why I'm sharing it right now. And a perfect example of that is what you just saw in reference to his perspective on evolution. He's already in a space where he's saying, this world is full of shit, no different than flat earth. What I'm saying is that we have to get the information from these teachers the same way we get the information from the observation of flat earth, because largely we're saying the same thing. This system is totally full of shit. It's designed to enslave us and keep us sick, keep us like bogged down with all of these theories, all of these illusions, so that the so-called powers that be can continue enslaving the masses. That's where I'm coming from. So anybody else is going to continue to get butt hurt or try to say, oh, well, this is this and that's that, you know, save that. It's pretty much save that. Or wait for a little while and then think about another way to explain yourself. I mean, give yourself some time to really, before you start getting all in the comment section and being a keyboard warrior about like, oh, well, I'm going to fix this with a comment. You know, good luck with that, because you're playing a movie for yourself and it really doesn't matter, because everybody ultimately is going to get what they see from their own perspective. You're only really talking to yourself largely in the comment section when you do that kind of stuff. I mean, I know other people are seeing it, but at the same time, you're talking to other people that are thinking the same way you are, which is ultimately, and I'm speaking to the people who just get in their emotions and get butt hurt. You're just, you know, rallying your team of emotional outburst crew members to, you know, get on your side when this ain't got nothing to do about your emotions. We're talking about the information. So I'll play another clip right now and just kind of roll into the next ones after that.
So this is a book written by a chemist, Carl Barnes. Nice fellow. He's a chemist, research chemist. And he's not a good talker, you know. He used to being in the lab with things that don't live. But that's okay, that's Carl. So he writes, and he sometimes can go off the edge with a lot of long terms, but I'm going to keep it very simple for you, because Carl wrote this book called Melanin, The Chemical Key to Great Blackness, as he called it, Melanin to the Great Blacks. That's a good book. You should privilege yourself by perusing it one day. Now, this melanin that I'm talking about, you see it in your eyes and it makes your eyes brown. But some people don't have any melanin. So when you look in their eyes, you're looking at the veins in back of their eyes, and therefore their eyes look blue and green and gray, because you're looking at the veins in back of their eyes. But you actually have an Isis, which we call an iris, named after a black woman. You call it the iris of your eye. That's named after a black woman named Isis. Now, we're talking about the inside of the brain. And these are brain cells increased to the size of a car. They look like little bubbles here. Look like little bubbles, but this brain cell is actually blown up to about the size of a car. And in the center of your brain is this thing here. It looks like a galaxy. We don't know what it is. It's really big in people's brains, especially black folks. We don't know what this thing is, but it's sitting right below your pineal gland. It's a gland in the center of your brain, the center of your landmass, the center of your brain, the same place where Egypt sits, in the center of the landmass of the earth. It's a gland there called the pineal gland. And we couldn't study it directly at one time, so we studied a pine cone and to study the spins and the cycles of this pineal gland. It's a little gland about the size of a pea, but it looks like a pine cone. And we call it the pineal gland, and it secretes this melanin, and it changes the melanin into hormones. These hormones stimulate action during the day. We call it serious action, serotonin. And in the evening, it makes you mellow. And this hormone is called melatonin. It makes you mellow. And the one that makes you serious during the day, we call it serotonin. So melanin controls when you're going to become a man, controls every clock in your body, controls when your eyelashes grow, when your eyebrows grow, when your teeth grow. Melanin synchronizes the rhythmicity of your system, keeps things from being in conflict, synchronizes motion, helps you dream, helps you have these thoughts that you didn't know you were going to have. Melanin does that. It's the key to everything. It's a man who showed you how this thing works. He said, these are the cycles in the body. Everything has a cycle. The tide goes out, the tide comes in. Everything has a cycle. There's day, there's night. Everything has a cycle. And you have all these cycles inside your body. The kidney has a cycle, the heart has a cycle, the intestines has a cycle. But something has to keep these things in order, and that's melanin. So a man said, I'm going to show you these cycles. I'm going to make them into little wheels and show you how these things are synchronized. And he said, here it is right here. It's a wheel clock. The man's name was Benjamin Banneker. He knew melanin. He said, you don't understand it, but I'm going to show you how this thing works. These are the cycles of your kidneys. This is the cycle of your pancreas. And he made them into wheels. And they all work, but they're synchronized by one rhythmicity, which they call melanin. That's where the wheel clock comes from. Every invention comes from your body. To know your body is to know everything. The camera comes from your eyes. The speaker comes from your ear. A nuclear reactor comes from your liver. A car motor duplicates your digestive system. Everything comes from your body. Crystals that they use in computers were learned from studying melanin crystals. That's where they got computer chips from. Everything comes from your body. If you want to know how to put something together, study the body. Computer chips duplicate melanin crystals. That's how they got it. No problem. You want us to discover something? Discover yourself.
So one of the main things that he mentioned in there is one of the main things that I've been mentioning in a lot of these videos is in order for us to understand this experience, the first step we should be taking is to start to understand ourselves, understand the experiencer. So as he was explaining the crystalline structure of melanin in the pineal gland, that's the doorway into what are all these processes? What are all these experiences that we're having when we're on psychedelic trips? What is that? What's going on there? Your mainstream science, your scientism, religion, your university systems acts like the pineal gland doesn't exist. In fact, it's trying to write the pineal gland out of history. As deep as the pineal gland is, as important as the pineal gland is to our experience, what makes you think, why is it not being studied? Why is it not being shared? Why are we not going into the depths of that? The same reason why herbs and plants are criminalized. That's why, because it's about control. If you study the pineal gland, you will be studying empowerment. You will be studying yourself. And that is a threat to the system. So, whose responsibility is to push the issue of researching this information? Whose responsibility is it to push the issue of understanding the importance of understanding ourselves? Whose responsibility is it? It's not going to come from the system. It has to come from you. It has to come from you. But the status quo of mainstream information is threatened. Why? Because the way the system got to power is by ignoring a lot of this information and keeping people in ignorance about understanding, understanding, and overstanding themselves. And what I'm saying is that the new version of that is to do the same thing that evolution theory and the Big Bang does. And now all these people who are calling themselves critical thinkers in the so-called flat Earth community are doing the same shit the old school mechanisms were doing. They're just getting into another comfort zone. They get into the complex information, like the complexities that he was talking about in reference to the body, in reference to your brain, your heart, the melanin, the relationships between the soul, the mind, and the body. All those complexities, just like you can understand the complexities of the not globe Earth realm. All of that. And it just gets shrunken down, put into a box, put a bow on it, and says, here, mainstream reality, make us valid. Acknowledge us, give us credibility, and usher us into the new world of understanding what flat Earth is really about. Please, mainstream society, do this for us, then everything will be okay. That's the people that you're following in so-called top brass of the so-called flat Earth community. It's bullshit. But that's the only way that they can present, that's the only way they can go about of understanding this information. And like I said in the last little build before the last clip was a defense mechanism for not showing your own how vulnerable you are. Is to make fun of people, to make fun of the information, to bully people, to victimize yourself, and just to complete or something like calling something pseudo. Like, what does that mean? Like, an hour's worth of a presentation of a very intellectual, very knowledgeable person. Like, somebody just wrote in the comment section, like, pseudo. What I mean, that what does that mean? Which parts are pseudo and which parts are not? Okay, if some parts are pseudo, then what parts are not? If some parts aren't, what is the relevance of those parts that are not? Because if there is anything that was said in that the presentation before last, if there is anything said in there, you better believe it's not being said by the university system. That's my main point. What is the information that we can gather from these teachers that's not being told to you, sold to you by the mainstream media? What is that information? Nobody's going to be perfect. There's going to be a lot of attachments to the stuff that's going on, like in reference to the globe references or the center, like Egypt being the center. Like, I hear all this stuff, but it doesn't throw me like it used to. Like, back in the day, I couldn't listen to Jiddu Krishnamurti. I couldn't listen to him because of the way I was perceiving him. Same goes for, teachers like Bobby Hemmett. I could not listen to Bobby Hemmett for a good 5 months, but I kept going and listening here and there, and then one something clicked over inside of me to that was saying, like, man, this information is more important to me. It's more important to my art, my expression, it's more important to that than my own feelings on the way that whatever's being presented, or the downfalls of, you know, what's coming, what's attached to that information. So if that's the case, then it's my responsibility to step into that space and understand what it is that's wrong with me. For example, is how I say it. Why am I not being allowed to see this information? Some of the times it's because people are full of shit. That's what happened with channelers. I stepped in there. I was like, man, this information is cool. I took the opposite route. I was like, man, this is cool. In the beginning, in like however many years ago, 5, 6 years ago, whatever it was, starting to question, you know, like, okay, well, before I started to question the reality of channelers, I was listening to the information. Like, what is this? There's a lot of stuff in here that makes sense, but it never really locked into me. So it was the opposite. I jumped into it at first without questioning anything. And then when I hit that wall, when I started to understand what was going on here, that's when I broke it. See, there's another, for me, there's another side where you just get kept away, and then you don't actually go into it and understand it. If you do go into it and understand it, you might find out that they're full of shit, or they're kind of full of shit, or they have a lot of information in there that's very relevant and crucial for the development of our interpretations of this reality. And it's only up to us to really figure that out and do something about it. But it has to be on our own time, in our own way. So a lot of the information that's coming from the teachers that I'm going to be sharing right now, it's not going to be, a lot of people are not going to be ready for it. And then they'll get into the comment sections, like I said before, and start, you know, blabbering on about their emotional, you know, oh, well, this is this and that's fine. That's good. Good on you. You are talking to yourself as you're pushing each button to make that comment. You aren't only talking to the commenters and the people watching the video and the people who made the video. You're talking to yourself. And a lot of people don't see that. They conveniently skip that part. So what I'm saying is that don't skip that part. Find out how and why you're feeling that certain way, and challenge yourself to do something about it. Stop crying in the comment section to other people about how other people are making you feel a certain way, like a little toddler. Get your ass up and do something about it.
Let's look at the human race. Let's look at the origin of the word. What are we getting into? Etymology. Comes from the word hue. And the root of that word is hue, which means color. Man means spirit of thinking or being. When you put hue with man, you get human being or black person. To be a person, by definition, you would have to be black. That's what the word hue means, pigment. To be a man, to be a human being, you have to be black by definition. That's why some people said, we're not man, we're just mankind. And they tell you that, don't they? So this is one of those things where you can find out the difference of races. Because of this melanin, it causes, when you cut your hair on the sideways, a slice as we call it, Orientals' hair is round like that. White folks' hair is divided like a kidney. Your hair looks just like the galaxy when you cut it that way. You're so in contact with everything. That's not outer space, that's your inner space. You're in contact with, even your hair spells this to us. Same process. So we look at that. You say, oh, yeah, okay, we're different. Our skin is different. Yeah. But we also have more vitamins and minerals in our body than any other race. The melanin causes you to have more vitamins and minerals in your body than any race. That can present a problem, a big problem, especially if all the lab values are set on the Europeans, on Caucasians, who have the least amount of vitamins and minerals in their body than any race. That's where the problem begins. Now we're coming along and you go to the hospital. They take your blood. They send it to the lab. But the lab values are based on white people's vitamins and minerals values. So when your vitamins and minerals way up here drop all the way down to theirs, which is rated number one, their lab value is going to say, ain't nothing wrong with you. You're healthy. You said, but I don't feel good. I said, well, according to, ain't nothing wrong with you. In your mind, something, but your lab values say you're fine. No, no, no. Your vitamin and mineral level dropped all the way down to their normal level, which means you are twice as sick. So you go back and you look at all the disease categories, and sure enough, you're twice as high in all of them, because you're trying to be healthy by another race's melanin value.
So that information goes into the psychology of racism, the depths that this system will go. So the way he explained the values of the healthcare system makes a lot of sense. This is why you have liquor stores. So this is the whole what he just explained to you in reference to the healthcare system is a scientific observation, a scientific interpretation of the reason why you have liquor stores on every corner of the inner cities. Why inner cities are, why the worst food for your body is the cheapest, is the most available to the people who are poor or can't afford stuff. This is why food is so expensive. Good organic food is so expensive, while cheap cancer-causing foods or cancer-causing foods are sold on the cheap. This is a definite. Who lives in the inner cities? Who lives in the third world countries? These are heavily melanated communities. This is an intelligent design. The very nature of the so-called healthcare system is designed to kill, to carry out the same mechanisms, the same programs that institutions like the KKK and white supremacy and white racism as a whole was designed to do. It's intelligent. It's an intelligent design to destroy. This is why you have a McDonald's inside the hospitals. So he went back to the etymology of explaining human, and then you have mankind, and all of these questions don't want to be answered by the so-called powers that be and people who are still in the comfort zone based upon the systems created by the so-called powers that be. Consciously and subconsciously, they are defending this program, whether they are bullying you, whether they're saying that your information is invalid. And a lot of people get in their high horse in reference to like flat earth. There's one person in the comment section was talking about before flat earth and after flat earth information, as if it was some kind of like Jesus, like before Christ and before Christ and Anno Domini. Like it was this whole thing. That's what this system is trying to do, is sell this commercial version of nothing matters except Jesus. Nothing matters except flat earth. Nothing matters except we're all human. Nothing matters except 1776. Nothing matters except the president. Nothing matters except Democrats or, you know, whatever it is that's being promoted by the mainstream media. That is a broken way to experience your reality. It's a broken consciousness. So what I'm saying is that we have to start asking questions about this reality and start listening to what's going on instead of just throwing stuff in a box and saying, oh, that's pseudo. Oh, that's this. Oh, that's that. Whether you're doing it because subconsciously you can't do anything other than that, or consciously you're doing it because you're priding yourself in something like flat earth or something like that, like, as if flat earth is going to save the day, as if the information of flat earth is just going to just be the next Bible. That information, whatever information is gathered from researching the not globe reality, that information that is real, that is true, that might have not even been completely confirmed yet, but in many cases, but in most cases, you could see like how much is real and how much is fake. But you have that information. If it's real, if it's based upon something, then you have the responsibility to see how other teachers, other work, other knowledge is also saying the same story. I saw that in many ways with a lot of the information that's coming from Dr. Laila Africa in reference to melanin, which is what I'm saying is, and other people have said this too, but what I'm saying and focusing on is the bridge between the body and the non-physical reality, the physical body and the non-physical reality, the spiritual nature of the body, the mind, and the soul. What's going on here? And studying the pineal gland, studying the body, studying the human experience, studying the psychology of society, of reality, of history, chemistry, alchemy, true science, and the true spiritual interpretations of this reality. Not all this other belief system stuff. The belief system stuff is if you need that, that's fine. Do that. But that's just another version of looking the other way. Some people need that. And it's not going to last forever. I mean, sometimes it will. People will live and die living in that belief system. And there's nothing wrong with that. You're going to do whatever it is you're going to do. But for the people who are claiming to be critical thinkers, claiming to be, you know, questioning their reality, it's going to hurt. It's largely going to hurt. That work is going to hurt. You're going to do work. You're going to sweat. You might bleed. You're going to stub your toe. You're going to sprain your ankle. You're going to do all these things as you're walking down that path, and you can't see what's on that path a lot of the times. And eventually you will heal, but and you will also learn from that experience. That's what I'm hoping to do with this video. So I'm going to jump into another clip.
This melanin causes you to have more life in you, more moisture in you. So we can just look at the earwax. This is the earwax of Northern Chinese, Japanese, 98. You have the most moisture in your earwax in any race. Isn't that something? I thought you said it would, under the skin, everything was the same. Oh, yeah. Your hair is different. Your earwax is different. You have more vitamins and minerals in your bones, which we call nutrient density. So under the skin, you're different. Whoever told you under the skin everybody's the same, they lied. Because biochemically, you are different. So we have to be treated differently. Whenever you have the high end of a lab value, like they take your blood, send it to the lab, and they show you these values, say 80 to 120 is normal. Well, if your value comes up to be 110, and that's almost close to the highest level there, almost, you got it. Whatever it is, you got it. The high end of that normal, you got it. The low end of that normal, you got it. That's how you interpret the lab values, according to your vitamin and mineral content. You got to translate this stuff. You got to make this stuff black. They ain't going to do it for you. Say, wait a minute. The normal value is numbers between 80 and 120, and I had 110. You got it. Whatever it is, you got it. That presents a problem. Because 80 to 120 is a normal range for someone who has a good blood sugar rating. But the problem is, black people get diabetes in the normal range for white people. They get it at 90, which is in the normal range for white people. You're walking around with diabetes. But you're looking at the normal values for a race that has another vitamin and mineral level than you, another melanin content than you. in the normal range for the diabetes test, if you're in the normal range on the high end of it, you got it. You got diabetes. That was proven over and over again. So anatomist in New York that does that research kind of work named Dr. Ann Brown.
So like I was saying, it's not just the design, the structure of the education system, the society as a whole, racism, control, the money. It's not only that. It goes down into the very structure of your body. We've been studied. We've been being studied by this intelligence. Not for our benefit, but for our utter demise. To completely work down your demise scientifically. This is how far this system has gone. It's not just about, oh yeah, you've been lied to, you have no meaning and purpose. That's sinister enough. If you can believe that they will lie to you about your universe completely, what makes you think they are not focusing that same kind of intent, that same kind of energy into the destruction of your physical body? If they'll lie to the masses to maintain a power grid, to maintain superiority based upon race. This is what I'm saying. This is why I get like, it's just ridiculous for me to see that people still defending like, or saying stuff like, we're all one and we need to just move on, when largely I'm sharing a lot of this information in reference to racism and all this other stuff because the system is still benefiting from that program and acting like it's not existing. The same thing that a lot of people that are doing are saying, we're all human, we're all one, we're all the same. You're doing the same thing that the system is doing to the masses. On purpose, that's happening. So when I bring up this information, I'm bringing up this information because it's largely pretty much taboo to even speak about it. It's taboo to even talk about what's going on. So when it's brought up and I get kicked back in the comment section or here and there or whatever from whoever about the information itself, a lot of people don't step back and look from the perspective of your shoes. They don't see that. In fact, they say your shoes don't even exist. What exists? This is what happens when I talk about genocide, colonialism, and the list goes on and on and on and on. Just imagine me going through the list of everything that smells and tastes and feels like genocide, colonialism, manifest destiny, racism, so on and so forth, white supremacy. Just the list of the way that system is designed. When people say in response to that, we're all one, it's all, you're basically saying, la 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 la, shut up, just whatever, just stop talking, we're all one, go back to work, everybody's sick, everybody's that, stop talking about, do you hear yourself? Do you see yourself and how you're actually defending that system? You're defending ignorance. You're defending an individual's healing process. You're defending their lack. You're stopping them from going into that healing process. And you're saying, none of what you're saying matters. What I'm saying matters. We're human. We're all one. That's it. There's no intelligent design behind racism. There's no intelligent design behind power and control. It has nothing to do with the races, because we know now that we're all human and we're all one. Everything that you've experienced and that you're talking about is basically invalid. It doesn't matter. Shut your mouth. Jump on board the happy team. Be with the oneness crew. Team unity. Team humanity. Sound a little familiar? Sound like that damn mainstream media selling you that Bernie Sanders bullshit and that Barack Obama bullshit and whatever they're getting ready to come out with the new age, the alien agenda, transhumanism, simulation theory, and all that other garbage out there. They're going to sell it to you from the same perspective. How do you think they're going to install a one world government? By having one type of people. They can't just come in and say, all of you need to just not be different anymore and just be one world. They got to give you the science behind that. They got to doll it up. And part of that dolling it up is to demonize and kick to the curb all of the other people talking about information that challenges their belief systems, their new age belief systems. Whatever it is, they have to say, oh, well, that's pseudo. Oh, well, that's black conscious community. Oh, well, that's that. You know what happens there? Ignorance happens there when that happens. When you just start labeling people and say, da, 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 da. No, listen. Get the knowledge. Get the information out of there. What are they actually saying? It's not just a little group of people. The terminology black conscious community in itself is a controlled opposition. Because what it does is it shrinks everything down to something that is just bland and just ridiculous. So this is the information that I'm researching, have been researching, and would like to have discussions about eventually. Once we get out of the defense mechanism world and the people getting butthurt and all their emotions and all that other stuff. You can't even talk about this information if people say it doesn't exist. I'm going to say this information in this video. Somebody's going to get in this comment section and say, we're all human. We're all one. This is all this. Everything you're saying is that. And then, you know, that's going to be representative of a lot of people. But I'm getting out of that space slowly but surely and kind of stepping out there, putting myself out there in reference to this information. Because there's going to be people out there that are probably going to say, oh, well, that person's this and that. And that. I mean, that's always going to be like that. It's not going to take away from what I'm researching, though. It's going to be observed. It's going to be, I'm going to see it and see how that works with other people. But ultimately, it's time to start taking some more steps to answering these questions that are outside of this bogus sort of just generic interpretation of our reality. If you say you are the soul, if you say you have meaning and purpose, you're the only one responsible to going into understanding what that is. Nobody else. It's up to you. And you're not going to do it by just guessing about what this reality is about. See, saying that you're all human and it's all unity, we're all oneness, everything is just this. It's just as simple as we're all spirit, we're all that. You're guessing. You're guessing your spiritual interpretation of this reality. Not only that, your psychological and your physical interpretation of this reality. If you've destroyed, if you've seen that the majority of the information in the university system and the public education system is designed to mind control you, a lot of people just say, well, I'm going to pride myself in not being a part of that now. And that's the distraction. Same goes for flat versus globe and people in flat earth. They pride themselves in not being about something instead of challenging themselves to understanding what it is that you now have to be. Let me say that again. You have people who are going to pride themselves, who are priding themselves in not being something. That's another world. It's another universe. It's another so-called community. Based upon gathering people around because you've prided yourself of not being about something. What I'm saying is that the other worlds, the other universes, the other perspectives, the other you is based upon challenging yourself. Now that you're not part of that, don't take pride in that. You could feel good about it, But if you step into priding yourself in it, that's another world. You're creating another world, no different than the world that you pride yourself of not being a part of. What I'm saying is that don't step into that. In fact, realize that that's what you do, because some people are doing that. And instead, challenge yourself in understanding, understanding, and overstanding your responsibility now in answering the questions that are now wide open for you to ask and answer, because the system that gave you those answers was full of shit. And that system is not, just being not a part of that system is not being enlightened. It's not being woke. It's not being conscious. See, those are all labels to trap you. That's largely what it all boils down to. The New Age community, the conspiracy theory, Alex Jones, all that stuff, it's designed for you on the macrocosm scale, because the microcosm is the information itself. It's very valid, but the macrocosm is you are priding yourself in not being something instead of actually being something. And that pride in not being something is now called woke, conscious, awake, enlightened. This is what the New Age community does. This is what parts of the flat earth community is doing. This is what parts of the black conscious community is doing. This is what the alternative news is doing. Oh, we are the best. Excuse me. We are the best because we are not mainstream news. That's what the alternative news is. So they're not challenging themselves to understand why the mainstream media is lying to you, how it's lying to you, how it psychologically affects you. They don't look into any of that shit. They act like it doesn't exist, because their universe is about priding themselves about not being like that. So they suck all these people into that universe, and now people are repeating the pattern of priding themselves in not being like something instead of actually being something. The conspiracy theory community does this. Alex Jones is a perfect example of it. It's another Hegelian dialectic. It's the invisible Hegelian dialectic. That's what's happening. And then you have these teams of people who are just sucking people into a world and saying, well, I'm a part of this world. I'm not a part of that world. Therefore, I am awake. I'm woke. I'm conscious. That's what the New Age community is doing. And it feels so real because these people that go in, they make it real. Like when I went through the New Age community, I was becoming another person. I never solidified it, because in order to solidify it in their world is to lock yourself into that universe. I never locked myself into that universe. I was always questioning my reality, because I knew that the same way that I just explained about people priding themselves and not being something, the same thing happens in the New Age community. And it makes it so real when people actually change, especially if they change for the better. What do you think the system is going to do now that they know that you know that they're full of shit and they've been controlling you with fear? What do you think they're going to do now? They're going to flip the script and say, we're no longer making money off fear. We want to unify everybody with love. It's another version of control. This is what the New Age community is doing. It's what it has been doing. It's why it's been around for a while. It's why it hasn't been really kind of expanded upon. It hasn't been spoken about. It's just been welcomed by people like Oprah. They're heavy hitters. Oprah teaming up with Deepak Chopra, Eckhart Tolle, Tony Robbins, and all these other people that are out there circling around Oprah. Best believe that's what they're moving towards. This is why I'm speaking about this information, because it's only our responsibility to research and understand what's really going on here and challenging ourselves to going into the depths of ourselves, the depths of this experience, the depths of the experiencer. Nobody else is going to do that for you. So as this system is imploding, you have to explode, in a sense, into the information that is largely only going to come from you challenging yourself to go there. So I'll play this next video. Before I get there, I just wanted to emphasize again the importance of, you know, questioning this reality. Like I said, if you can understand that heliocentrism was designed to completely mind control people, what do you think the healthcare system is doing? What? And all this information, see, this is just a science that is specific to a particular race of people, a particular style of people, biology of people. It's not at all far-fetched to see this stuff existing. Especially when you understand cannabis, a plant, is criminalized. Psychedelics are criminalized. Mushroom, a fungi, ayahuasca, like this medicine, these are criminalized. Why? What you call a healthcare system is not a healthcare system. It's death. Everything is designed to produce cancer in your psyche, in your body, and in your soul, or in your relationship to your soul. All of this is designed to have an effect on you. Until we take that perspective and realize that, we're not going to be really addressing the issue. We're going to be addressing subcategories of the issue. So when you see these people, like people in my family have died from sicknesses that were a result of this poor nutrition, horrible nutrition. People are still suffering from those side effects today. Family members dealing with this nutrition, this counterproductive nutritional consciousness that's designed to destroy you. That's not a little thing. It's not something to be joked about. It's not something to be pushed to the side. It's something to be researched and brought to the surface. So when I hear people saying, oh, well, that's pseudoscience, or that's this or that's that, kiss my ass with all that bullshit. That's just childish and ridiculous. And that's the downfall of using these labels like Black Conscious Community and all that other stuff. This is why a lot of people are not affiliating with all that stuff now, because of the design of self-destruction that's inherent in there. It's how you perceive your reality. So I just wanted to emphasize that point one more time, because this is where I'm coming from. Like, when I share this information, I'm not sharing, like I said in previous videos, this is for the future generations. I'm speaking for in my head, I'm speaking for my little cousins that are like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 years old. My little goddaughter and her friends and all those people who don't have a voice yet. And when they do have a voice, what's going to be the topic of discussion? That's my question. And if the topic of discussion is just a bunch of prideful ass people sitting around some kind of desk talking about we're so great because we're not like that, that's not a world that I want my little cousins and my goddaughter and my family members, future generations, I don't want them to be there. I don't want them to be in that world with these childish ass people priding themselves in something that ain't got shit to do with them, the expansion of their consciousness. It's just another mind control program. So I'm gonna say something about it. So this is the next, let me jump into the next video or little clip before I close it out.
Now, here we go. The races of humans. This is how races are classified according to white people. Not according to me. This is not Dr. Africa said. This is according to John Hopkins University, Emory University. This is how they classify races. Rated one, with the lowest melanin content, is the Caucasians. Rated 2 and 3 are the yellow, mixed, and brown race, which you call the Orientals. Rated four are the brown and red people, Native Americans and Japanese. Rated five are the black, brown, and brown people, which we call the Native Indians from Mexico. The Mexicans, Himalayas, you know that race I'm talking about? Rated six with the highest melanin content is black folks. You are rated the highest on the human scale by white people. Did you know that? No. That'll present a problem. You go in a classroom, they say, they start breaking this thing down to you. You say, we rated the highest on the human scale here. You say, okay, and we come from Africa. Okay, that means I can think better than you. I may not think faster than you, but I can outthink you. Yeah. So, okay. Is this stuff I'm making up? And I say, no, you're not making up. You really respond to life better than I do. Then they start showing you books, The Magical Child by Joseph Pierce. Then they start to show you another book, Infancy in Uganda by Mary Ainsworth. And these are books about them studying black children whose mother was on natural food and breastfed, and father was on natural food and breastfed. And they studied these children, and the child's born with these parents could sit up at birth, look his mother and father in his eye, know its name, know his mother and father's name at birth. Documented. The Magical Child by Joseph Pierce. They didn't believe it. They went back 10 years again and studied the same thing. Same thing happened. They didn't believe it. Mary Ainsworth went back and studied it. Infancy in Uganda. Same thing. Yes, you grow at a faster rate than white people. You have the highest, the fastest growth and development of a child than any race. You can be toilet fed, toilet trained at 1 year old. It takes a white child 2 years for their nerve to grow to that muscle that controls their bladder. You're raising your children like retards and wondering what's happening. Because nobody told you you had melanin. Nobody told you it causes you to have the highest growth and development. Nobody told you you learned how to toilet train earlier. No one told you you learned how to speak earlier. No one told you. Why should they tell you that anyway? You think they're going to tell you something so you want to be free? There is a biochemical difference between black women's breast milk and white women's breast milk, because white women's breast milk has the least amount of vitamins and minerals in it of any breast milk. Black women's breast milk, I just told you that. Even white people know that. You ever heard of a white mammy? Am I getting to you here? Even they know who has the best breast milk. Okay, maybe you think I'm going a little too far. The brother's gone off the edge here. He's gone up the... I'm just telling you, you go down south. I'm telling you, they know who has the best breast milk. You don't know, but they know. So we got to go back here and rediscover ourselves for what we are. And that's what this science is all about. And I have the normal medical lab values, the normal daily allowances set by, for Europeans by Europeans. The breast milk is set on the white woman's breast milk, which has a different fat and protein ratio. What I'm saying is, if you put a black child on a white woman's breast, it reduces the child's sucking time on the nipple and reduces the child's response if you take the breast out of their mouth. It reduces the ability of the child to bond to itself, to bond to its mother, to bond to its culture. Just by switching the fat and protein ratio in the breast milk, which you call celiac or semilac, which is based on a white woman's breast milk. Not a black woman's breast milk, a white woman's breast milk. So you give that to your child and it reduces the child's ability to bond to its mother and to bond to itself. That's why you got drive-bys. It's a biochemical thing. Oh, yeah. This racism started long before you want to go to school with white folk, sit on the toilet next to white folk, and be integrated. This stuff started long before that.
So you can see in that clip how, like I was explaining, the liquor stores and the healthcare, so-called healthcare, the hospital, like it's designed. It's designed from your body. We talk about the legal name program being, and money being a problem, and racism being a problem, and poverty being a problem. Another part of that that predates any of that stuff goes into the very nature of the food, the chemistry of the food that is being pumped into your child right after they're born. That's how deep this program of control and destruction goes, down to the breast milk. The breast milk. This has been studied. This has been known. It's not just the money. It's not just the system, the rules, the regulations. It's the alchemy of your experience, the alchemy of your relationship to the experience itself. And it's nobody else's responsibility other than yourself to understand why these systems exist, how they exist, what's going on. But too many of the times we get caught up following who is talking about whatever they're talking about, or who's beef between this beef, and then picking sides. And you never think for yourself. Caught up in the consciousness of who. We'll never know what's going on. Sure as hell ain't never going to know how what's going on is going on. And you won't go into why what's going on is going on. And chemically, we're being kept in that space of stagnant sort of consciousness, stagnant physicality, a stagnant psychology in every way. From the breast milk to the Similac to the education system to the food when you grow up and become an adult, the food for your mind is garbage. The food for your mind is Similac. The food for your soul is Similac. Mainstream religions, mainstream pop culture, this is Similac. We're in a Similac culture designed to implode you in every single way.
So we're talking about this melanin and the melatonin levels and how it just starts going lower and lower as you age. What they have discovered is that this pineal gland that sits in the center of your brain, and white folks will start getting hard around 12. By the time they're 20, the gland does not even function. That's what I'm talking about. Their pineal gland calcifies, gets hard by the time they're 13 or 14. Oh, you know it. You see it all the time, but you just don't believe it. Oh yeah, why ain't they got some rhythm? That's what you'd be asking yourself. And I'm saying technically they don't have no pineal gland to make this stuff that cause rhythm. You saying they sure ain't got no rhythm. I wonder why that is. Duh, they don't have the thing that controls rhythm in the body. Melanin, that pineal gland that squirts out this melanin is calcified, turns into stone by the time they're 13. And they tried now, they tried. They draw steps on the ground, everything. They try, they be doing that stuff. You say, dang, they got the steps on the ground, they hear the music, and they're still dancing like, you know, what's going on with them people? It's the melanin. That's what I'm trying to tell you. So science attached to this stuff. Melanin makes your system burn energy more efficiently. So you don't need the stuff chemically that they need. You don't need that. See? You're efficiently human. But when you're not taught that, you don't know what human is. Human is your ability to be in contact with that inner voice, that deep silence, that dark crystal inside of you. What God put in you, you're just in contact with the God in you. That's all you're doing. So we're looking at this melanin. We're trying to say there's a purpose for it. And there's a way to do this. If you want to control somebody, just destroy their melanin. This is how you do it. This is how drugs work. Drugs work on their ability to destroy melanin, speed it up, or slow it down. This is how we measure the effectiveness of drugs. This is how it's done.
So, an example of what he was speaking on in reference to the pineal gland and the calcification of so-called white people, or the shrinking down of it. I actually, the first time I ever discovered that study was when I read something about the soldiers that were coming back from Vietnam. A lot of them were studied, and they did this study. I'll try to find, you can look it up for yourself, but I'll try to find that. If I don't find it, you can find it. The study was based upon the difference of the size of the pineal gland in melanated soldiers and non-melanated soldiers, or white people, so-called white people, so-called black people. And what they found was that exactly what Dr. Laila Africa was explaining in here is the shrinking of the pineal gland at a particular, I mean, throughout their studies, they found this. They've seen this. And for me, like then, I didn't know where to put that information. I didn't know what to do with that. But now at this point, with the questions that I'm raising every day and where I'm challenging myself to research, excuse me, that's a very important thing. It's very important to understand why. Start asking a question about why. Like, look at that reality and start to figure out why this is going on. Because this is going into the science of why we are different. Because the next control grid, this is why I focus on the information of why we are different, because it's relevant, it's healing, and it's also counteracting the idea of we're not different at all that's being sold to us by the next control grid, the New Age community. And even a lot of these people are just getting caught up in their emotions because they don't know how to deal with something like the mental illness of racism and the transition out of that space. They don't know what to do with it. So they overcompensate by saying it doesn't exist, and basically it never existed. And if you talk about it, something's wrong with you. They're not actually doing the healing. What's being done is they're putting an emotional band-aid on the situation and not really handling the cancer. That's what all this unity and oneness is going on. And what I'm saying is that by going into understanding, and overstanding the beauty of our diversity, the beauty of our differences, we'll start to heal a lot of these wounds, and we'll simultaneously start to expose a lot of the information that's been projected into our reality to attack us, to attack our consciousness, to attack our relationships, our culture, our future generations. We are under attack. Everybody is under attack right now. What I'm saying is that there is a science and a specificity of that attack that is not just something that's dealing with money. Oh yeah, money keeps people poor, and the Illuminati run the money, and that's how simple the story is. If that's how simple the story is to you, just get off of this video and don't look at any of the other videos I got on here anymore. If this is where you're coming from, these videos are just gonna piss you off. But that's the system, that's the way it's being sold to us by the system. This is why you have Alex Jones out there talking about the Patriots versus the globalists, because he wants you to focus on the Illuminati, the money, the power grid as it is. So once whatever Alex Jones gets that he's asking for, the power grid is not going to change. It will only appear like it's changing. If he gets exactly what he's asking for, what do you think this system will look like? if Alex Jones, for people who are still supporting Alex Jones, let's just say Alex Jones got everything that he asked for, and for people who are still following Alex Jones, also understand that he's being mocked by Stephen Colbert on the Tonight Show or the Late Show, whatever it is. He's being mocked. That means he's part of that. He's part of that crew, in a sense that it's a confirmation in reference to the consciousness that the system wants people to be at. He's being mocked because they want people to look at that information so they can get caught up in his bubble. It's not only to make him look stupid. It's to make people get caught up in his bubble. Because once they start to have the appearance of things changing, like I said, what will the world look like if the Patriots, if the manifest destiniers get exactly what they're asking for? If the colonists, if the genocidal psychopathic maniacs get exactly what they're asking for, or the genocidal psychopathic sympathizers, if they, the ones who are avoiding all this information and only want to save the system, they get exactly what they're asking for, what is it going to look like?
We say that Prozac stops the ability to absorb serotonin, which comes from melatonin, which comes from melanin. It's right on the label. Prozac, serotonin reuptake inhibitor, says it on the label. Serotonin, melatonin, melanin. It works by stopping the body from absorbing melanin right there in front of you. That's how the drug works. That's how you gauge the age of the brain by how well it absorbs melanin. That's how they know how old mummies are. Dark crystals, carbon, melanin. That's how they play the game. How does a person become diabetic? You say, I don't know anything, but I know what he said. You have to destroy the melanin. Sure enough, you look on the pancreas, there are melanin spots on there. We call them islands of Langerhans. Black little islands on the pancreas. The islets of Langerhans. German for little islands. These little black islands on the pancreas, once you destroy them, the person becomes a diabetic. That's how they become diabetic. It's the ability to destroy melanin, speed it up or slow it down is how we measure a drug's effectiveness. That's how the game is played. Okay. I said that's about melanin and diabetes. Okay, well, what else happens here with this melanin thing? Let me see. Prozac works by stopping your body from absorbing serotonin. Then what's going on here is there's an attack on your blackness. This is called chemistry. They told you that's why they call it chemistry. So when they want to make a chemical, it has something to do with chemi, with black. They say it. It's in the word. Chemi means black. They're using chemistry to control you. They're using blackness to control you. It's right in the word. It's the ability to destroy life.
So that was a good clip to kind of close this out, because largely what it's boiling down to is just that. It's the system that's against life itself. It's the system that's against harmony. It's the system that's against peace and nature as a whole. And the intelligence, the destructive intelligence, the parasitic consciousness behind that is not, it's not stupid. It's not as simple as what people claim to be or put it up to be when they say things like, we're all human, or they say things like, well, we're all one, so racism doesn't exist, so we don't need to look at that information. You're not doing anybody any justice by taking that stance and taking that position. You're actually amplifying ignorance. You're amplifying the lack of healing when you allow yourselves to get caught up in those emotions or those labeling sort of perspectives that say stuff like, oh, well, we don't need to even look at melanin. We don't need to ask any question. We don't need to look at any of this. And it's racism doesn't have anything to do with this. And this system told you that you live on a ball. It told you you came from a monkey, from a Big Bang, that you're nothing. It told you all of this. Why? So that you will destroy yourself. It doesn't have to destroy you anymore if you're destroying yourself. That's what the system banks on. It is a science of destroying life. That's what this system is banking on. And in that destruction, it makes a profit off of your destruction. And the process of getting to that death, your work, they call jobs, is enslavement. For you to be born into this system, sick and diseased, so they make a profit off of your sickness and disease. If you ever understand that white supremacy is not only psychologically making you think and act a certain way, it's trying to make a profit off of this by making you feel weak and stay weak physically, psychologically, and spiritually. If that's the case, then you have to understand that there's a science behind maintaining power over the 9/10 of the people on the planet. Chemically, biologically, scientifically, alchemically, that is there. That information, what I'm saying is that the doorway into that information is to gather the information that's already been presented by the teachers who came before us who were speaking about this, like Dr. Laila Africa, and start to talk about it, start to discuss it. Because it is disgusting. This is a disgusting topic. And it's not existing. If you don't talk about it, it's still existing. That disgusting nature, that disgusting reality, that self-destructive consciousness is still existing in your reality. You're just ignoring it. You're just acting like it's not existing. But it's still there, and it's weighing you down, and it will continue to weigh you down. It will affect your consciousness as long as you keep avoiding it. Because this is the question of you. The science that's being brought up in here, the questions that are being brought up in this video, is basically chapter one of what I was explaining in previous videos about the relationship between the experience and the experiencer. The body, the mind, and the soul. What is it? What are the bridges between the body and the mind and the mind and the soul? What are the bridges between all of them? How does it fit together? Scientifically, psychologically, spiritually, both for the positive and how has it been affecting us from the negative, which this parasitic consciousness has been doing. You can't just focus on one side of the story and think that that's going to be it. That's what the system, the Hegelian dialectic system, wants you to do. Because while you're focusing on one side of the story, what do you think they're going to do? They're going to sell the same story from the other side that you weren't paying attention to. So no different than they jump from Democrats to Republican presidents and Democrat to Republican senates and all that other shit. They're going to do the same thing with the destructive intelligence and this fear-based control system. They're going to say, oh, we've been in a fear-based system of control for so long. Now we need to jump into love and let's sell it to you with the new age. They prepped you with Barack Obama. They're prepping you with this whole women's movement, this women's empowerment movement. They prepped you with Bernie Sanders. They're prepping you with Oprah. They're prepping you with all these activists to make it look like things are changing. Nothing will change. it will remain the same, and in fact it will only get more complex, and it will still be designed, it will still be maintaining your destruction. And until we start asking and answering these questions, none of that will actually be addressed. It will continue to grow. So that's what I wanted to share with this video. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for people who are supporting this channel, sharing and liking and commenting on the video. I do appreciate that. And also people who are responding to other people's comments. Like, you're a part of this too, in reference to, I mean, if you feel guided to or whatever. Like, when I like it, just so people know, I like it when people actually see a comment that's just horrible and then they actually respond to it and kind of shut it down or expand it so people see what's really going on there. Because that's what I try to do when I comment in response to a lot of these comments. I do that, but I like it even more when other people do it because I don't have to do it. And it actually creates more of a dialogue because it feels different when it's coming from another individual rather than the person who made the video. So I try to hold back, and then when I revisit some of these sections of comments, then I'm happy to see that's going on, because it is a counteracting sort of energy when people do that. Like when somebody just vomits on the comment section and I see it, you're going to have a lot of people who agree with that. They're going to agree with that because that's what the status quo is based upon. But it really is nice to see people. It's kind of like reassuring to know that what you're talking about makes sense to people. They're receiving it, and so on and so forth. So thanks again for the support. I really do appreciate it. And until next time, from all my relations, peace, love, and harmony.